everyone, I'm Anne-Marie from Brambleberry.com, and today I have a different kind of video for you. We're talking soap making theory. Specifically, how do you design and customize really great cold process soap recipes? So if you're just starting out and you're new to soap making, all of these oils might seem a little bit intimidating. And I'm gonna tell you how you can use all of them to create well-balanced, beautiful conditioning bars of handcrafted soap. But before we get to that, let's just go into a teensy little bit of a science refresher to talk about saponification. To do that, I have my trusty friends, Plato A and Plato B. So let's talk about the saponification reaction, what makes lye water turn oils into soap. So if this is our oil, each of our oils have something called a saponification value, which is a fancy word to say this is how much lye it takes to turn this bit of oil into soap. Each oil has a separate one, which is why a lye calculator like the one you find at Brambleberry.com is so helpful in creating your own soap recipes. The lye mixes with the oils to turn into soap, meaning each of your lye molecules match up and mate up with a oil molecule. This process is called saponification. And when that happens, the final product is a well-balanced bar of soap. So once the saponification process has happened and our oils have mixed with our lye and they have bonded together, you have a completely different product. You have soap. A well-balanced bar of soap will never have any active lye left into the final bar of soap. And if you're using the Brambleberry lye calculator, all of your bars will be well-balanced, barring human error like mismeasuring on a scale. So in a nutshell, or the soap bowl, that's how you make soap. You mix lye water and oils together. You have to have lye or sodium hydroxide to make soap. So now that we've talked about the science just a little bit, let's talk about oils and how to pick and choose and formulate a recipe. There are so many different oils to choose from. How do you start? Well, first think about what you want your final bar to be. Think about the function. Do you want your final bar to have lots of lather? Do you want it to be conditioning? Is it for sensitive skin? From there, that will lead you down the path to picking your oils. All the oils have different qualities to them, and they also have different price points. They also act differently in your soap. So broadly speaking, there's two basic categories of oils. There's your hard oils, which I also use that term broadly to include butters, and then there's your soft oils or your liquid at room temperature oils. So some popular soap making oils that kind of are in this category are like palm kernel flakes, babassu oil, palm oil, coconut oil, cocoa butter. These are two different kinds of cocoa butters. Shea butter, mango butter. These are some really basic ones, and many of them come solid at room temperature, or rather all of them come solid at room temperature, and you have to melt them down. So for example, this is coconut oil, and it was solid at room temperature. Then I tossed this microwavable bag in the microwave, and now it is liquid at room temperature, so you can pour it. Palm oil is another one that comes solid at room temperature. Palm oil is really interesting because it's made up of 8 different fatty acid chains. And if you don't melt the entire thing of palm oil, you might run the risk of only getting some like the liquid fatty acid chain or some of the more palm stearic fatty acid chains. So with palm oil, you always want to melt the entire thing and shake it up, mix it up before you add that to your soap recipe. And then there's the other category of oils. Soft oils, and these are oils that are liquid at room temperature. Some really popular ones are like olive oil and sweet almond oil. Jojoba is pretty common, hemp seed oil. A lot of different oils in our soft oils category. They're typically used, and this is just a real broad generalization, about 50% or less for your total recipe. So every oil you choose is going to give your bar slightly different properties. And so when you're thinking about formulating a bar, what's important to you? For many people, gentleness and cleansing abilities are very important. For others, they really want luxurious oils and conditioning. So let's talk about some things that are both luxury and really gentle for skin. So oils that add to the gentleness of your bar would be things like olive oil, rice bran oil, canola oil, sunflower oil. Avocado is another really common ingredient that can go both for the gentleness, but also many people consider it to be a luxury oil. So let's talk about those luxury oils. Typically the luxury oils are used at 10%, 15% or less, well, because of price point, and they also don't usually add much to firmness or hardness. luxury oils include, but are definitely not limited to, like, say, jojoba oil, borage oil, tamano oil, evening primrose seed oil, hemp seed oil. There's so many good ones, and I love to use them in my soap because they do add a little bit of conditioning. They do add some kind of feelings of your skin feeling nice and supple when you're done. But again, I usually keep them at 15% or below in general in my recipes. So what these oils do for your skin and your bar of soap is gentleness and luxury and conditioning. What they don't do so well is make a really hard bar of soap that lathers really well. Can you make soap with 100% olive oil? Yes, that's called Castile soap. And you'll notice Castile soap has very small, tiny bubbles, really conditioning and lovely, but not like a really wonderful, big, copious amounts of lather. If you try to make soap with, say, 100% sunflower oil, squishy, slimy, ugh. And that goes for most of these. So what do we add to make a firm bar of soap that lathers well? We're gonna need some of those firm, solid at room temperature oils that we talked about earlier, like, say, coconut oil or palm oil, or maybe even some cocoa butter. In terms of what adds to your lather, really, lather is a triumvirate of oils, meaning the holy trinity of oils to get great lather, great firmness, and good gentleness is olive oil, coconut, and palm. The coconut oil is what adds to the really copious lather, along with its friend, castor oil. And then in terms of firmness, what you're looking for is, say, palm oil, shea butter, mango butter, cocoa butter. All of those add to the firmness of the bar. Now, interestingly enough, palm oil and coconut oil in conjunction produce better, more solid, long-lasting bubbles than just coconut oil alone. In fact, many people find coconut oil, say if you made a bar with just 100% coconut oil, somewhat drying to skin because of its high cleansing ability. The best recipes are always a blend of oils, but just to kind of really drive this point home about how each oil has a different property, these bars are made with 100% of one type of oil. So this is 100% coconut oil. You can see how white this bar is. It's really hard. It obviously traced pretty quickly. This is 100% cocoa butter. And this bar is a little bit more sticky, obviously did not trace very quickly. And then this bar here is 100% olive oil. And olive oil, of course, is Castile soap, but for the first kind of few months of its life, it's gonna be really, really sticky, low lather. This one doesn't have really any ability to harden up, and it takes a while in the mold just to get it out without kind of tearing it. It really does get better at about 1 year. And in a regular batch of soap, it's usually used between 33% and 50% to add to that gentleness of the bar of soap, but it does so much better when it's mixed with other oils to create a really fantastic hard bar of soap. The cocoa butter has very little lathering ability, but you can see already it is so much harder, and that's because we started with cocoa butter, right? Cocoa butter is solid at room temperature. It's going to naturally be harder. This is gonna be a really slimy, kind of icky bar of soap, interestingly enough. Cocoa butter, 100% cocoa butter soap does not make a great bar of soap. And then we have our beautiful, beautiful white coconut oil that traced pretty quickly, and it's gonna be a little bit in between. It's not nearly as hard as the cocoa butter, but it's definitely more along those lines. And 100% coconut oil soap, it does lather in salt water, but that's about all it does because it will really strip the skin of natural oils because of its high cleansing ability. So this is our coconut oil, and it, you know, this is just made a few days ago, but you can see this lather is just gorgeous. It's big, it's bubbly, it's got really good staying power. This is a nice bar of soap, but like I said, it's gonna really strip the skin of its oils because it's got such high cleansing ability. So this is our cocoa butter one, and you can see already that this lather is way more kind of milky and thick and dense. It's not a copious lather, it feels, as opposed to silky, it feels more kind of slimy, and it's definitely, the bubbles are not sticking around. So this is our olive oil, and you're like, oh, that's not bad, right? But it feels extra slimy, and it is like snotty. Do you guys see the snot? Like, it's just like, ew. So olive oil soap definitely needs to cure extra long in order to not only get the gentleness, but also to get it to actually kind of have some actual lather as opposed to slime. So I mentioned the cleansing ability of coconut oil a lot, and you're like, well, where does this term cleansing ability come from? There's this really interesting theory out there called the INS theory, which basically measures the molecular weight of an oil and the unsaponifiables in the oil to tell you what they think the oil is going to do in soap. They give weight, an actual numerical weight, to these kind of different qualities. Some soap makers like this as kind of a general guideline, almost like putting like the bumpers in the little bowling alley to kind of keep you from, to keep you in the straight and narrow to make good soap. I don't tend to use INS numbers when I make soap because the theory is somewhat flawed. In theory, a perfect soap for and using the INS numbers is 160. But honestly, you can get to 160 using some really not great oils. Like for example, this bar of soap, which is 100% cocoa butter, it's 160. So in theory, it's a perfectly balanced bar of soap using the INS numbers. But as we just saw, it's actually not a perfectly balanced bar of soap. So if it were me and I was learning how to make soap and formulate soap recipes for the first time, I would not rely on INS numbers. And I would just learn how to use all the different oils at your disposal to create the best bar of soap that you love, that matches the hardness, the firmness, the social values, the gentleness and the skin conditioning, rinse off ability, lather, all of those things. And just kind of keep playing and refining until you get what you want. So let's talk about how you play and refine. So a good place to start is the holy triumvirate of oils, which is olive oil, coconut oil, and palm oil. And I usually will start with about a 34% olive oil, 33% coconut, 33% palm. And that will give you a well-balanced bar of soap that has good firmness and hardness, rinses away cleanly, and has really solid lather. That's a great place to start for a bar that's going to give you plenty of working time, but then also set up pretty quickly. Because remember, coconut oil is adding that cleansing ability, palm oil is adding firmness and hardness and acting as a secondary lathering agent, and olive oil is adding that gentleness to your bar of soap. This is a great place to start for your first batch when you're just starting to customize and trial and error. Another great option to start with, especially if you have kind of more dry or sensitive skin, is more like a 30-30-30. 10 something special, meaning 30% coconut oil, 30% olive oil, 30% palm oil, and 10% something else, right? Sweet almond oil, cocoa butter, tamanu seed oil, anything else at that kind of 10%. So that's another really great way to get some luxury oils in, to get some gentle oils in, to get some oils that have some skin conditioning properties. Say you want to tweak your recipe. First thing to remember is all of your oils do need to add up to 100%. So where you're taking an oil out, you are going to be replacing it with another oil. So what if we want to make a more gentle recipe and we take that 34%, 33%, 33% holy oil triumvirate and want to make that more gentle? Well, what I would do is I would increase the olive oil to make it more gentle and then decrease my coconut and palm oil, probably in equal percentages. So maybe like a 50% olive oil, 25% palm, and 25% coconut. Another common reason to tweak your recipe or an existing recipe is say you want to replace an oil. Either you are out of an oil and so you're like, oh, what do I do? How do I make soap today because I'm out of X, Y, and Z oil? Or for whatever reason, you want to change the recipe to exclude an oil entirely. So, for example, if we want to take palm oil out of that holy triumvirate of oils, first we think about what is palm oil adding to that recipe? Well, it's adding hardness and firmness. So what can we replace our oil with that would also add hardness and firmness? So in this case, I'd probably do maybe a little bit of shea butter, maybe a little bit of cocoa butter. And so again, we need everything to add up to 100%. So in this case, I'm going to up the olive oil to 50%, and then I'll probably do about 25% of coconut oil, and then I have 25% left in my formula that I need to replace with the cocoa butter and the shea butter. So in this case, you could split it up however you want. So you could do 12.5 and 12.5, you could do 10 and 15%. However you want to do it, it's going to need to replace the palm oil, which again was adding the firmness and the hardness. And you might be like, oh, this is so much math. I'm not a fan of this. Great news. The Brambleberry Lie Calculator can calculate your entire recipe by percentages. Legit. So you say, this is how much soap I want to make. These are the percentages I want. And then you just hit calculate and it tells you how many ounces and then of oils and how much lye to use and how much water. Another way to choose the type of oils you want to use in your bar is when you think of the design your bar is going for. So for example, if you are going to do swirling, you want a recipe that's going to give you a little bit more time and fluidity to work with it. That's why Brambleberry has a quick mix specifically for swirling. If you want a bar that has layers, you're gonna be thinking about, ooh, maybe I wanna have a bar that has like 60% hard oils or more. Or if you're gonna be going just for a plain bar, you could have a lot of time to work with it or a little time to work with it. It's kind of your choice. So be thinking about really what you want in your final bar for a design and then pick. So for example, liquid oils in general stay liquidy for longer. Oils that are solid at room temperature tend to thicken your soap up faster. So for layers, think more solids. For swirls, think more liquids. Thanks so much for watching today's video. I hope you're coming away with more confidence in how to choose your oils and customize your recipes. Remember, there is a ton of recipes at brambleberry.com in the studio section so that you could just, well, use any of those or use them as templates for yourself. If you like this video, please give the thumbs up below. And of course, if you haven't subscribed, what are you waiting for? We want to notify you every single time we come out with a new video. Until next time, happy soaping. And then, I think I did. Then there's, I'm not gonna put anything on it yet because I don't want it to be shiny and disgusting. Glare, glare, glare. Pacham, pacham, pacham. Right.